was not over. Baby, I worked this out for sure. It's gonna be colder. Now you force open the door. I know you better.
Oh, then it's me. Look, I got your message, okay? I don't think you're quite getting this. I'm here to make amends. I'm here to hang out with my boys, spend time with my boys. I can't just take them away without me seeing them. It's Christmas, for Christ's sakes. I'm their dad. What is it you want from me? You want me to beg? Then this is me begging you, please let me see my boys before you go today, please. Just... And... Shez.
Hi, Graham, love. How's Dublin?
Well, have you seen much of Declan and Porrick?
No, not at all. Now I get a message that she's taking them to their ma's. They can't stand the sight of me, Shez. No,
that's not true, love. Now, you go back around there pronto and you don't take no for an answer, do you hear me?
You know what the worst thing is? Worst thing is I don't even blame him. I don't.
There's something important I have to tell you.
Yeah, go on.
Steve's leaving today. Him and Doug are going to America for good. But I don't think that's what he wants.
Why? You had to tell me this, why?
Because I don't think it's what you want either.
I made a deal with God. I can't break that.
But that's assuming that the best thing is to stay away from Steve. What if it isn't? What if he wants to see you more than anything else in this world?
I gotta go now.
No, wait, Brad. Brad.
Hello, Auntie Sharon.
Hello, darling. Is your daddy home?
In the bathroom.
Oh, and is anybody else home?
Lucas.
Okay, well, why don't you go and play with some of your toys and I'll have a wee chat with Daddy, okay?
Look, Steve, I know this isn't the time or the place, okay, but I have to tell you before Doug gets back, and it's killing me. I don't want to watch you and Brendan throw things away, okay? Because I know you love him as much as he loves you, and he does love you, by the way. That's why he's staying away. See, when you were sick and you were in hospital, he made a pact with God that if you got better, he would stay away for good. Because he'd do anything for you. He genuinely thinks that you're better off without him. But I know that's not true because I saw it yesterday and I know you love him as much as you ever did. Come on, babe, please open the door.
You packed your nan's perfume? Oh, and her slippers.
Chill. They're in the bag.
What about air presents? Doesn't look like my drum kit's in that case.
Who says you're getting a drum kit anyway? I'll have to wait and see. Did I not make myself clear?
Hey, Dad. How you doing?
You want to play the drums?
He already does. Been having lessons at school the past year.
Really? Listen, if you wanted a drum kit, you should have just said. You want Anton Porrick?
You used to think we needed a father. But we got over that fairly quickly, didn't we, Pat?
Well, if that's not told you all you need to know. That's us. You two hop on.
Hey, you guys have a great Christmas, you hear? There's £100 in each of these. They'll do you instead of a present, eh?
No, you're all right.
Please, Declan.
I'll have his too for helps.
Oh, will you now?
What I told you. I don't want you showing up here trying to buy your sons.
It's Christmas.
We buy gifts at Christmas. We don't give wads of drug money.
I didn't know what to get them, okay?
Well, then you need to ask yourself why.
I'm trying to make an effort here, Arlene. Please, just let me make amends, please.
What is it you want me to say?
You think you can just waltz back into their lives like nothing ever happened? Click your fingers and they'll forget. You neglected them when you were living your double life.
The one with the secrets and the lies.
The violence, the crime. I tried to protect them from all that, but not anymore.
Last time Declan came to see you, he nearly died of a heroin overdose.
My Paddy. He doesn't even know you.
He's the lucky one. For the love of Christ, take the hint. We don't want you in our lives.
Thank you. Craig, please get off the bus. Craig, this is... Craig, this is... Please, Craig!
I'm so sorry, Doug.
No, Cheryl, you're sorry that I heard you. We're supposed to be friends.
We are. I never meant to hurt you, hon. It's just... I think Steve deserves to know the truth before he makes this huge decision.
His decision's been made, all right?
Yeah, and it's forever.
What's the truth anyway? I mean, the monster that beat him black and blue might still want to get with him? Yeah, that's great. Let's pop open the champagne.
I understand you're angry.
Yeah, you're right, I am.
But I also know you really want Steve to be happy. And this isn't fair on you either.
And Steve's not happy with me.
No. He loves the bones of you.
That's not good enough, right? He's still hung up on Brendan.
I think things didn't work out between Brendan and him because Brendan was ashamed of who he was. But I think things have changed now. I think he's changed. And I also think that both of you at least deserve to know the truth. Then you can make your decision from there.
So you choose to tell us on the day that we're leaving to start a new life together.
I'm sorry. I looked at Steve and I saw it. I knew. I had to say something.
So what are you going to say?
I don't know. I think that's up to you now.
So this is it then?
Well, it doesn't have to be.
What do you mean?
I mean, are you sure you want to do this? Because there's still time.
Wait! You can't leave without another hug.
I'm really gonna miss you guys.
I'm gonna miss you more. We had a laugh, didn't we? Come here. You're the bestest friend anyone could ever have, you know.
You can't get rid of me that easily. I like being in a vineyard too.
Well, you can come visit whenever you want.
Thanks.
I'm gonna go tell Texas and the kids to hurry up.
They're just in the shop getting a drink.
Come here again.
Are you telling them that I said goodbye? Our troubles and stuff, but I won't ever forget him. Never. It means more to me than he'll ever know, like.
Don't worry.
I'm doing the right thing.
You know what, mate? Stick your drink. I'll go elsewhere, yeah?
Yeah. I'll get it. Pour another one while you're at it.
What should you do that for?
For my own sake. It's getting too painful to watch.
You after something?
Please. Don't flatter yourself.
There.
We will like it there. You can go to Disneyland if you want.
You two are going to have the best time ever.
I wish I could come in your suitcase with you. Get away from here.
You okay?
Yeah, we'll be. Once we get up there.
Come on.
Hi.
Hey.